Hello students, we are going to continue with our sixth chapter, that is directing. Okay, today we are going to start the last element of directing, right? We have already completed supervision, motivation, leadership, and last one is communication. In today's lecture I have included characteristics of communication, meaning of communication, and methods of communication. What are the various methods through communication is being done? Okay, starting with the concept of communication. See, in 11th standard we have already studied, right, that what is the meaning of communication, what is the process of communication. Okay, communication, that means, you know, that in general terms we can say that, you know, exchange of information, ideas, thoughts, feelings, right, through the various, you know, that through oral communication, through sign language, through verbal or non-verbal communication, right? So that is called as what? That is called as a communication. But here the communication is the most important thing, right? Because see, generally when the, you know, that in whatever the instructions that are coming from the top level, that will be done through a proper communication channel, right? That instructions and orders that flows from, you know, top to middle and middle to bottom, right? But whatever the instructions, whatever the orders that has been given to the middle level and the bottom level, whether the task that has been performed as per the instructions or not, that need to be checked out, right? So the bottom level, they are going to what? They are going to send the information to whom? To the middle level and the top level. And that flow, that is called as what? That is called as a reporting, right? That the process of providing information, or that goes from from bottom level to middle and middle to top, that is called as what? That is called as a reporting, right? And through communication, the world is becoming what? The world has become a global village, right? Like we have already seen into the 11th standard, right? That when if you have some orders to give, like, you know, like import or export, then you can easily give orders to the abroad, right? Like people, those who are having, you know, that internet facility with them, they are going to what? They are going to continue with that particular orders. Okay, right? So communication, that is what? Communication is very important in regards with the directing, because reason is what? See, ultimately when you are going to motivate a person, you are going to, you know, communicate with the particular individual or the employee. Okay, and ultimately what you are going to do, you are going to identify that in what areas the person is lacking about, right? And you are going to give that motivation. But motivation, that can be done through what? That can be done through the communication. Okay, instructions, orders, whatever that are coming from the top level, that will be done through the communication. It can be written communication, it can be oral communication, right? Whatever the information that has been given to the bottom level, the task that is being performed as per the instructions or not, that also need to be checked out. So that particular information, that will be what? That will be sent from bottom to middle, middle to top. And that process is known as reporting, right? See, many times the question, it will be asked into the 1 mark or a 2 mark of a question, that what is reporting? So reporting, that means a process of the information that will go through the bottom level to middle, middle to top, that is called as what? That is called as a reporting. Okay, and communication, what it includes? It includes, you know, that giving orders, instructions, receiving reports, attending complaints or solving them, that is called as what? That is called as a communication. See, this is also the one of the way of a communication that we guys are doing, okay, through a digital platform, through a digital channel. Okay, whatever the things I'm doing here, I'm recording the video, uploading on YouTube, sending you the link, and you are going to listen to it. That is what? That is the communication. Okay, and ultimately reporting is must for the communication. Why reporting is necessary? Why we are taking test? Why we are calling you for the meetings? Why we are calling you for that, you know, that notebook checking? Reason is simple, because we want to know that whether whatever the that, you know, that efforts that we guys are making as a teachers, as being a student, you are performing that task or not, that we need to check. Getting my point, right? So ultimately from this, what we can say, that communication is what? Communication is a two-way process, that two persons are involved, that sender and the receiver. Okay, I am the sender, you guys are the receiver. Okay, getting my point? Then let us understand the meaning of a communication. First, it is what? It is a process of exchange of words, letters, instructions, and opinions. A simple meaning, right? That whatever the things that, you know, that exchange of ideas, exchange of thoughts, whatever the instructions, orders that has been given, right? That is called as what? That is called as a communication. According to Mann and Sommer, that is what? It is an exchange of facts, ideas, opinions, or emotions by two or more persons. See, communication, it can be done. See, whatever the things that right now we guys are doing, sender is the one, but receivers are many, okay, getting my point. So communication, it can be done between two person or more than two person, it depends, okay. But ultimately what is the main thing here, that is exchange of thoughts, ideas, facts, emotion between two person. If a single person is communicating, then he must be mad. Getting my point, right? Communication, it can be, it cannot be done by a single person talking to himself or herself. That is not the way, that is not the communication, okay, right? So here, that the corporate meaning or the corporate level, if we know about, if you want to learn about the communication, that communication, it can be done through two way, that is formal and informal, okay. Formal communication, that means whatever the, you know, that like, suppose you have that, you know, that if you remember the diagram of a functional organization or a linear organization, whatever the communication, that will be done through the structure, that is called as what, that is called as a formal communication. Informal communication, that means, you know, that it can be in the oral form, and anyone can do, top level to bottom, bottom to top. There is no any kind of, you know, that hierarchy that is going to be needed, okay, fine. Now moving ahead with the characteristics of communication, in that first, it is a goal oriented process. See, in the organization, communication that is being done for what purpose? For the achievement of the objective, achievement of the goal, right? Whatever the goal that has been set by the top level management, that will be conveyed to the middle and the bottom level. Okay, yes, we are going to achieve this much of a sales, we are going to increase the number of employees by this and this numbers. So it is a what, it is a goal oriented process. Communication, it starts with the goal, right? Like suppose I have set an objective, yes, I want to achieve this much or this many, okay, I will be conveying that message to my fellow workers, so and so only they are going to understand. If not, then target will not be achieved, okay. So communication is a goal oriented process. Second, clear words and language. Understand, clear words that are needed, language that is also going to be needed. That means whatever the language that is understood by the bottom level and the middle level people, that message should be conveyed into that language only, okay. And clear words, no double meaning will be there, okay, right? There must be a correct, that what we can say, that, you know, that correct interpretation of the message that would need to be done by the receiver. What am I saying? Like, as a sender, the receiver is not understanding, he is interpreting in his own way, right? Like I'm saying, yeah, tomorrow you have to come, no time is mentioned, no place is mentioned, then there will be a confusion, right? Many of you will come, chalo, we will go at 8, we will go at 9, we will go at 10, right? At my home, at the school, nothing mentioned. Then that is not the clear words and the language that is there, okay? So whatever the message that top need to convey to the middle and the bottom, they need to, what they need to use the clear words and the languages, okay? Third, it is a two-way process that I have already and make you understand into the concept, that it is a what, it is a two-way process, that two persons are involved, senders and the receiver, right? In a corporate or in a business unit, managers, they are going to what, they are going to send information regarding what, regarding the objective, policy, procedure and rules, to whom, to the middle level and the bottom level. And what is the understanding of the middle level and the bottom level? What are they, you know, that whatever the information that has been sent, whatever the orders that has been given, they have been accepted or not, that will come from the bottom level of management, right? Information in the form of a report from middle to middle and the top level, right? See, ultimately report that will be prepared by the bottom level management, then it will be sent to the middle level. Middle level is going to analyze all the reports, all the information, and then they are going to send to whom? They are going to send to the top level management, okay, fine. Next, it is a continuous process. See, communication is a continuous process, right? Every time new targets will be set, new objectives will be set, new policies that will be made, new information that need to be set, whether from the top level or whether or the bottom level, right? But it is a continuous process. It starts with the inception of a business, that is from the very beginning of the business, and it stays, it continues till the end of the business unit. Right, wherever there will be, you know, that activities of a business will be going on, communication must be there, okay. Fifth one, that is many equipments. Now various tools are there, right, you know, that to make a communication, like oral or written communication or message or correspondence, telephone, fax, internet, mobile phone, SMS, telex, etc., right? Nowadays we are using the social media, this YouTube, WhatsApp, that is what, this all other social media, Facebook, right? We are going to communicate with each other with many tools, right? But ultimately managers and the, you know, that those who are working under them, they need to select a proper equipment or a proper method of what, proper method of a communication that can be easy to understand and that can be conveyed to everyone. Okay, next, many types and methods. There are many types, like in oral, written communication, external, internal, through that, you know, that sign language, anything, it can be there. It depends, right? Most of you, you know, that you guys are using a sign language into the examination, right? Okay, so many types and methods. Then it is a motivating activity. See, if you want to motivate someone, we have already understood the meaning of motivation, right? If you want to motivate someone, if you want to guide someone, what you need to use? You need to communicate with that person, right? You need to understand that what are the problems of the person is. Then you are going to solve those problems. So that will done through communication, right? Like, you know, that you are coming to me, you're telling me, yes, sir, I have a problem in this and this topic. I listen, I understand. I'm not explaining you anything. I'm not motivating you. Then what is going to happen? Obviously, communication is not going. Communication is the most important part into the motivation factor, right? We need to talk with people. We need to convey the message to the people. We need to convince the people, okay, yes, you can do it. Okay, so to motivate the people, to motivate the worker, what we are going to need? We are going to need communication. Okay, next, relation with the administrative process. Okay, see, I have make you understand the difference between management and administration in the very first chapter. Management, that will be done by the top level. Administration, that will be done by the middle and the bottom level. Okay, middle level and bottom level people, they are the one who are going to, you know, that do the maximum administration task, that is the implementation of the plans, procedure, policies, whatever the things that has been designed or done by the top level management, right? Now while implementing such plans or the policies, middle level and the bottom level people, they are going to face difficulties, right? So those difficulties can be solved through a proper communication, right? Like, I am the middle level person, I will be understanding the problem of the bottom level and conveying message to the top level, okay, these people are having a problem in this or implementing the orders or the instructions, okay? And accordingly, through the proper communication channel, that can be removed through training or whatever the things will be there, right? So it is used for what? To fix the problems of the workers or grievances of the employees, okay? So it is related with the administrative process. Administrative or administration, that means to implement, right? Last, that is human process. Human is at the center. Communication, that will be done between the humans, right? The words, that feelings, and that whatever the things will be there, that will be exchanged, right? That, you know, that existence of a fear, that feelings, anger, etc., right? Two people, they are, you know, that if we are, if they are, you know, they are friends, so they are going to talk with each other with the feelings and everything. If the two people, they are enemy, there will be feeling of anger will be there, right? So communication is completely a human process, okay, right? So these are the characteristics. Now, what are the methods of communication? This chart is given in your textbook, right? It can be oral, written, visual, audio, audio visual, and silence. Oral, that is conversation, that right now people, you know, that in lectures and everything that they're doing, conversation, discussion, dialogue, talk, lecture, group discussion, etc. Right, if you are converting conversation, you are doing a conversation with your friend, right, that is the oral communication. Whatever the things that, you know, people are doing through when they are, you know, gathering at a particular place. Written communication, these are newspaper, magazines, pamphlet, advertisement, letter writing, manuscript, email, etc. These are the written communication, right? Written communication mostly will be used into the formal organization or for the formal communication. Okay, oral communication, that will be done, or methods of oral communication, that will be adopted into the informal organization or into the group of our friends, right? Visual, that is map, pictures, figures, graph, colors, symbols, signs, etc. For audio, tape recorder, radio, telephone, teleconference, right? And for audio visual, like film, television, internet, computer, video, cassette, etc. Here, that we are using audio visual. I'm speaking, you can see me, right? You can see the particular PPT that I'm making and you are making notes from it, right? So that is the audio visual. Silence, that is a silence gesture, like, you know, agreement, silent agreement, yes, silent disagreement, no. Gesture, like, you know, that you're waving to your friends, you are asking the answer of the and MCQ that in a silent gesture when you are sitting in a class, right? Getting my point? Okay, so this chart that you need to draw in your notebook while making your notes from it, okay, right? Just go through it. If you have any doubt, do let me know. Thank you.